In 2019, the world population consisted of almost 7.7 billion people. 49.6% of the world population was female in 2019, which is 3.8 billion women. That is a big number. Women play a big role in the health of our world, but women's health is at a crossroads, says the WHO. And the following is coming from reports of UN Women. Did you know that it is estimated that 60% of chronically hungry people worldwide are women and girls? While on average, women make up about 43% of the agricultural labor force in developing countries. Also, women make up more than two-thirds of the world's 796 million illiterate people. Data from 68 countries indicates that a women's education is a key factor in determining a child's survival. Educated women are more likely to have greater decision-making power within their households. And research has indicated that when more income is in the hands of women, child nutrition, health, and education improves. Further, maternal health is a human right. Yet, every 90 seconds, a woman dies during pregnancy or childbirth. Most of these deaths are preventable, but due to the gender-based discrimination many women experience, they are not given the proper education or care they need. The pandemic affected women the hardest. According to the World Economic Forum's Gender Gap Report, closing the gender gap has increased by a generation during the pandemic, from 99.5 years to 135.6 years. This is astonishing, and it will be a challenge to do something about this. These are all factors that show we need to empower women in different ways. One way is to empower them through access to health and especially technology for their health. Women's health is therefore worth investing in. But let us take a look now at women in healthcare. If we look at the share of women among all women workers employed around the world in health and social work, in most of the countries, more than 50% of the women work in that sector. In the United States, according to a report from McKinsey, nurses are more than 80% women. And according to UN Women, women even make up 70% of the health and social workforce. Yet, only 30% of leaders in the global health sector are women. So, although it gets better, looking at closing the gender gap, we need more women in leadership in the health sector. In the future of healthcare, is the increased use of technology. When we need more women leaders in the health sector, this means that we especially also need more women in the health technology sector. Until today, more men than women are designing and developing technology for healthcare. This, while women make more use of healthcare. Data on the annual per capita healthcare spending by gender and age group for the United States by the Kaiser Family Foundation shows that women from the age of 19 years spend more on healthcare than men. Some say that is why femtech, which refers to software, diagnostics, products, and services that use technology to support women's health, is on the rise. Femtech aims to give women more control over their health and lives. However, that is not enough. We need overall more female leadership, both in the health sector as well as in the health technology sector, to have more gender balance and a better effect for women's health. So, how can we start doing this? First, we need to keep promoting gender diversity. Looking at the pharma, biotech, and device subsectors, gender diversity is especially important in composing the development and marketing teams for therapies and solutions to treat conditions that disproportionately affect women. This enables companies to more authentically and responsibly market to female patients. This is according to another McKinsey report. Second, we need to create an interest and good future for women who aspire to have a leading role in healthcare technology. The beneficial opportunities should be clear. Also, how the role can have real added value to women's health and society. Then third, show the world who are those influential women in healthcare technology. They are there, but can you name one of them right away? This may not be easy for everyone. When the world knows about these female leaders in healthcare technology, girls and women can follow these role models, and then they will start seeing these roles as an option for themselves too. Fourth, we need to connect the regular healthcare sector and the healthcare technology sector more. Not only that, we need to connect the regulators, the healthcare sector, and healthcare technology sector, and strengthen this triangle. Then we can book rapid progress in involving more women in the process. The pandemic has shown us that our health systems need change and strengthening. Through cooperation, we can make that possible. There's a lack of correlation between women working in healthcare and women in healthcare technology. Also, when looking at the women healthcare workforce and technology, according to OECD statistical data, female health workers remain underrepresented in highly skilled occupations. In highly skilled occupations, women also need more technical skills. But as the women are not in these occupations, they can also not develop these. So, we spoke about leadership. Women need to lead from the front. But there is more we need to pay attention to when it comes to the transformative role of women in healthcare technology. One is improving research. For technologies used by women and related to women issues, women in technology and healthcare technology can play a big role in developing the systems that are more user-friendly, a majority of which are women. When more female researchers are involved and we include more women participants in research, we will get a better focus on solutions for women in healthcare. Did you know a female heart is different from a male's heart? A woman's heart and some of its chambers are smaller than men's. The walls that divide the chambers are also thinner, and also the veins are finer. These are a few examples of the differences. Cardiovascular disease is among the top causes of death for women. This is one of the aspects to also take into account when we develop technology solutions in healthcare. So, what more is there? Training. There need to be more women technology experts to train the medical staff and doctors to use medical-related instruments. In many countries and cultures, women like to be trained by women. But not only this. Furthermore, why do we need more women technology experts, especially in healthcare? It's because in the future tasks in healthcare, will be replaced by technology and robots. When employees from healthcare can make the switch to another sector, in this case, the healthcare technology sector, this will be beneficial to prevent job losses and, in time, reskilling. What is my own story of healthcare with technology? Why do I find it important that we pay attention to this topic, because I see the shift taking place in healthcare from traditional medicine to technology-led medicine. I studied medicine, and I slowly see the role of the doctor changing from practicing to more management and leadership in healthcare, also technology management. We can only make these transitions happen when we in time pay attention to the opportunities and challenges. When we look at the current pandemic, I want to give you an example where we could have done better. In a recent example of the situation of COVID-19 exploding in many countries, staff was not trained to run oxygen machines and ventilators. Women trained in healthcare technology could have played a big role in saving many lives. So, what can the future be? What is the transformative part in the contribution of women? Not only raising and using their voice, not only contributing to connecting technology with healthcare, but especially to together think on how we with healthcare technology can strengthen our healthcare systems. What does our healthcare system need at the moment? What are the pressing issues? This will be a continuous process to explore. So, overall, this will be a win-win situation for health, independence, and empowerment of women. We need to strengthen the role of women in healthcare technology. At some point in our lives, maybe now or later, we will experience healthcare. And what kind of healthcare do we want for our future and that of our children? With that question in mind, we should strive for the best, and we can only do that when we work together to make it happen.